How's it going, lads and ladies? It is Petrifying Pumpkins here, and today I am back with a PSVR news video. So, not exactly hot off the presses with this. This has been known for a while now. I got a couple of things to talk about. The first thing I'm going to just jump into is something that has me kind of depressed. And the reason I'm somewhat depressed is that for, I want to say over a year now, we've heard about this kind of mystery AAA open world virtual reality game that Rockstar Games were working on. Now, not actually Rockstar Games, the studio themselves, but they had this kind of satellite studio somewhere in Australia called Video Game Deluxe, I think. We'll go into the article about it in a sec and we'll know for sure. But those are the guys who did the LA Noir virtual reality case files. And from what I can tell, they just do virtual reality stuff for Rockstar Games. And they kind of, well, they didn't officially hint us or tease us. It was just something that people gleaned from job listings that they were working on a AAA open world virtual reality game, which kind of got all of us speculating, excited. You know, what was it going to be? Was it going to be an original IP built from the ground up for virtual reality? Was it going to be GTA 5? Red Dead Redemption 2, perhaps? Something like that. Fast forward to last week or so, when Mark Zuckerberg and the Facebook gang had their kind of presentation or showcase or whatever you want to call it, where they revealed Meta was the new title of the company instead of Facebook. So it's the Meta Quest now instead of the Oculus Quest. And they revealed that they had got their little reptilian hands on exclusivity for GTA San Andreas VR. So we didn't know it at the time. My fingers were crossed that this wasn't the game that this Australian Rockstar studio, satellite studio, whatever they were, Video Game Deluxe, that this wasn't what they were talking about when they were making those job listings over a year ago. But Jamie Feltham over here from Upload VR, dashing my dreams and my hopes against the wall back on the 1st of November. GTA San Andreas VR is developed by LA Noir VR Studio, hiring for multiple projects. So there is a kind of a silver lining here. It's not all doom and gloom. We'll talk about that little part at the end as we get to it. I've highlighted the important stuff. So the upcoming virtual reality version of Grand Theft Auto San Andreas for Oculus Quest 2, which, by the way, they didn't show a glimpse of it, not even a screenshot, so we have no idea what that looks like. I'm assuming it's going to be kind of running on the remasters that are coming out soon. It's going to have that kind of a style to it, but who knows, maybe they'll do like a ground up thing. We'll wait and see. It's been at least partially developed by the studio that teased a AAA Rockstar virtual reality game in mid-2020. So back then, they stated that they were gearing up for a new project, a AAA open world title in virtual reality for Rockstar. Tantalizing stuff. And then Mr. Zuckerberg did his thing. And since that announcement, they've put out a new LinkedIn message saying, and yes, their company name is indeed Video Game Deluxe. So they confirmed that this new version of San Andreas is at least one of their projects it's been working on. So as announced at the Facebook Connect event, we are beavering away on one of the world's best loved games for VR. The post reads, we are heavily recruiting for this and other projects. So there is that glimmer of hope that this isn't the only thing. So maybe they're still working on GTA 5 virtual reality on the side. This is just what they're doing for the Quest, and then maybe they're doing something else for PSVR 2 or PS5 VR, whatever the hell that's going to be called, whenever the hell that's going to be revealed. Rumors are saying December. We'll wait and see. The developer is encouraging anyone interested in joining the studio in Sydney to reach out. It's not clear if Video Games Deluxe is the only developer behind the upcoming port, nor if San Andreas VR is definitely the exact AAA VR title the studio teased last year. Again, just that little bit of hope. It still feels like a bit of a gut to the punch because, you know, this studio in Sydney, I don't think they're like a huge studio. I'm not sure how many projects they can realistically be running at the same time. Fair enough, you can be developing one game like San Andreas, and maybe you can be like working on another title in pre-production, but to have both of them going full steam ahead at the same time, maybe a little bit more unlikely. I mean, it all depends, you know. It could be a case that they're not the only studio working on us, and if that's the case, there's a bigger chance of us seeing GTA 5, Red Dead, something like that on PSVR 2, 5, VR, whatever. So that's the first thing I wanted to talk about. The other thing I wanted to talk about was this event that may or may not be happening in December. Now, this is kind of extremely late. This was first teased back in, was it September? Yeah, this article is from September. So basically, some guy from Reddit given details. Apparently, he correctly predicted when one of the showcases was going to be, so that's given him some credibility and whatnot. That's not necessarily why I'm listening to him, or why I'm kind of intrigued by this, is because AJ from, you know, Without Parole / PSVR Underground has been teasing this on Twitter. Well, not teasing us, but, you know, suggesting that it's possible there's a rumored showcase going to happen in December. And of course, Without Parole were the ones who leaked all those details about PSVR 2 / PS5VR, whatever it's going to call. I wish they would have leaked the name of it so I could stop doing that little dance. So it is possible that they know more than they're letting on. So they might have, you know, a little tip, a little inkling, whether it's AJ, whether it's Brian Paul, I don't know. But they might have some kind of information there, someone telling them something, or maybe he's just gone off this, in which case it's, you know, something you should definitely take with a bucket of salt. But, you know, if we're looking at this logically, this person is claiming that a PSX event is going to return. So PSX events, or PlayStation Experience, the full title, were these kind of fan events that PlayStation used to do during the PS4 years, and then they stopped, but they were very good. They would reveal, like, really good games, like Uncharted 4 was revealed at one of these things, I believe, and lots of cool shit like that. So PSVR 2 being revealed at something like that seems plausible. You know, it's a big enough kind of event that people will be looking. But keep in mind, it will be kind of competing with Jeff Keighley's Game Awards. So, I mean, you have to see how that's all going to work out. I don't know. But yeah, if PSVR 2 is coming out next year, and I do believe it is, I think most of us kind of agree at this stage it will be coming out next year, then surely they're going to reveal this thing soon. I mean, Project Morpheus was revealed, I believe, years before the PSVR 1 came out. You know, Sony kind of give you a year head start before they, you know, release the hardware. So yeah, this isn't something I want to go in too much in detail with, and like in terms of reading out this article and going into the sources, because I've gone through the sources and it does seem kind of, you know, a little bit like you need an awful lot of salt, because this person has a history of also like bullshitting and stuff in the past, apparently. But just keep in mind that December could be when we'll hear something about PSVR 2. Fingers crossed. So yeah, and with that, I will end this video. Let me know what you think about this whole Rockstar thing. If you think there's more than one project going on there on the side, maybe Sony have their own exclusive lined up from Rockstar, which would be nice. It seems like there's going to be a big battle between Facebook, well, Meta, and Sony over snatching up kind of exclusives now. Facebook are getting Meta. I'm going to have to get used to saying that. Meta are getting, like, you know, really, I don't want to say greedy, because Sony do this all the time and it's like a done thing, but they're getting more competitive, I think, is probably the correct term, which is good for Quest fans and whatnot out there. But it's going to have to force Sony to react in kind, I would imagine. And then let me know your thoughts on, you know, when are we going to see this? If we're not seeing the PSVR next month, when are we going to see this thing? You know, PSVR 2, I should say, the next generation PSVR headset. And with that, I'll end this video. Thank you very much for watching. And in particular, thank you to the Patreons whose names are on the screen as we speak. They are the top tier Patreon supporters. Tradition, Chrome, Pete Hawkins, and Daniel the Pumpkin Patch Kid. Thank you very much for that support. It is greatly appreciated. I know my output has been shockingly poor in the last few months, and I'm going to try and work on picking that up a little bit, maybe getting some streams and stuff back up as well. So yeah, thanks for the support, and I'll see you in the next one. No, I won't, because I still have to give more thanks. I have to thank Decepticon for letting me use his music in all of my videos. Man, I'm all over the place. I can't even remember how to do a fucking outro. And I think with that, I can end this video. And this is where I tell you to stay nice and moist. So stay nice and moist. All right. Bye-bye. Petrifying.